Morning students, today we are going to learn to draw the diagram of a carpel showing its internal structure, the germination of pollen grain inside the carpel and its fertilization. Inside the carpel we are going to show the ovule and various parts of the ovule. So let us start with the diagram. Let us first draw the carpel. So upper expanded portion of the carpel is the stigma. Then we have is the style. Then we have is the ovary. Now inside the ovary we have is the embryo sac. So you can show embryo sac. Embryo sac is the region in which we have is the egg cell present, the female gamete present. So this way you can show the embryo sac. Embryo sac at the bottom, at the base, is having a opening, and this opening is called the micropyle. This opening is micropyle. This is your embryo sac. Okay. Inside the embryo sac, on the upper side we have three cells called the antipodal cells. In the center we have is two polar nuclei, called the polar nuclei, and at the base we have is the egg cell which is surrounded by two synergids. So this is egg cell, these are two synergids. So in total inside the embryo sac we have seven cells, 1, 2, 3, three antipodal cells, two polar nuclei and one egg cell and two synergids. So let us label these. These are antipodal cells. These two are the polar nuclei. And this one is the egg cell. And these two are the synergids. This one and this one, these two are the synergids, right? Okay. This one is the egg cell, right? Okay. Now just see, let us label the major parts of the carpel. This is the stigma, you know. This is the style. And this one is the ovary otherwise. You know this. Now let us show the pollen grain. Pollen grain, it falls over the stigma, and after that if it is the pollen grain of the same flower, then same flower means same species of the flower. Like if we have the carpel of rose plant and we have the pollen of the rose plant, then this pollen grain, it starts germinating. Germinating, it starts forming a pollen tube. This kind of pollen tube is formed, and this pollen tube keeps on growing. It keeps on growing and growing, and it travels inside the carpel. It travels inside the carpel and it reaches the embryo sac. So like this, you can show the pollen tube. It is going all through the carpel and is reaching the embryo sac. Inside this pollen tube we have is the male gamete, right? The tube nucleus and the germinative nucleus are present inside this pollen tube. So this is pollen tube. And this one is the pollen grain. Inside the pollen tube we have is, these are the male gametes or the male reproductive cells, which are going to fuse with the egg cell and cause fertilization, right? Also, I can show you here, this ovule is being protected by protective coverings which are called the integuments. So protective coverings are there which are called the integuments. So, and inside the integuments, here we have is the food laden cells, because the growing embryo requires the nourishment. So the ovule is being covered by these food laden cells. These are called the, these cells are called the nucellus. These are forming the nucellus. Right, so this is our ovary, and so you can label this one as ovule. We are making the structure of ovule. Basically, we have shown all these parts are the parts of ovule, right? And ovule is protected by integuments. Integuments, these are the protective covering of the ovule, which are giving protection to the ovule. So this is all about the structure, showing the carpel, inside which we have is the ovule, right? This is the one ovule shown. So inside the carpel you can see major parts of the carpel, the stigma, style and the ovary. Inside the ovary we have is this ovule. Ovule is protected by coverings, protective coverings, which are called the integuments. And inside the ovule you can see these food laden cells are there. Now these food laden cells, these contain the food material and which provide nourishment to the growing embryo. Embryo which is formed after the fertilization of the egg cell with the male reproductive cells, which are coming from the pollen grain, right? Then we have shown the embryo sac. Inside the embryo sac we have three antipodal cells, two polar nuclei, one central cell called the egg cell, which is the female gamete, and then we have two synergids, right? And we have shown this embryo sac. Embryo sac at the base is having a opening which is called the micropyle. Now pollen grain is forming a tube, pollen tube, which enters inside the carpel, and it enters the embryo sac through this micropyle. Micropyle, through this opening, the male gamete, which are present inside the pollen grain, the male gametes, that is the generative and polar nuclei, they enter the embryo sac through this micropyle. The male gamete, it fertilizes, it fuses with the egg cell and is causing fertilization. After the fertilization process, the seed is formed. So this is all about the structure of ovule, showing the embryo sac, germination of pollen grain, and the fertilization of the egg cell with the male gamete. Thank you, children.